The United States can no longer afford to be the world's policeman. The national debt has skyrocketed to over $21 trillion, and the federal budget deficit has ballooned out to almost $800 billion. This crisis has prompted United States President Donald Trump to call on every cabinet office in the U.S. government to slash its budget by 5% by fiscal year 2020. And according to the Deputy Defense Secretary, the U.S. military will have to slash its budget by $33 billion to reach this target. The Pentagon could probably cut 5% from its budget simply by cutting wasteful spending. But newly released figures from the Congressional Budget Office reveal that much more drastic cuts loom on the horizon. As entitlement spending and interest on the national debt consume an ever-increasing portion of America's gross domestic product, the government is going to be forced to cut defense spending to its lowest level since the 1930s. This fulfills a major Bible prophecy.
By my reckoning, at some point within the next decade, the U.S. will reach the crossover point at which it will be spending more on debt service, on interest payments, than it is able to spend on defense.
Financial historian Niall Ferguson has warned that nations and empires usually fall apart when the cost of servicing their debts exceeds the cost of defending their borders. The United States is dangerously close to this tipping point. The Congressional Budget Office recently disclosed that the interest on the national debt rose to $371 billion in 2018. That is a 20% jump over the previous year, and roughly half what the nation spends on its military. Based on current budget projections, the government will spend over 3% of the nation's gross domestic product on interest payments by the year 2028. Meanwhile, it will spend 6.8% of the nation's GDP on healthcare, 6% of the nation's GDP on Social Security, and only 2.6% of the nation's GDP on the military. That means base defense spending is projected to fall from 3.1% of GDP in 2018 to 2.6% of GDP in 2028. The last time U.S. military spending fell to such a low level, the Great Depression was devastating the U.S. economy and Nazi Germany was rising. If powers like China and the European Union continue to boost their defense spending towards 2% of GDP, they will quickly catch up to the United States in terms of military technology and prowess. The late Herbert W. Armstrong explained in his landmark book, The United States and Britain in Prophecy, that the Anglo-Saxon peoples that settled the United States and Britain are actually descended from ancient Israel. This means that all Bible prophecy regarding end-time Israel is actually about the United States and Britain primarily. Chapter 14 of this book specifically explains a prophecy contained in Micah chapter 5, verses 7 through 15. This prophecy explains the wealth and dominance the United States and Britain would have in the time just before the Messiah's return. And then explains how this wealth and dominance will be broken as both nations collapse suddenly. In this prophecy, God says that he will cut off the horses of Israel and destroy their chariots. Then he says that he will cut off the cities of the land and throw down its strongholds. In other words, just at the moment that America reaches the zenith of its power, God will cut off its armaments and throw down its strongholds. He will break the pride of America's power. Why? Because the people have turned away from God's law to embrace false teachers who teach lawlessness. They endorse sins like abortion, adultery, drug abuse, homosexuality, lying, Sabbath breaking, and sexual promiscuity. America's current debt woes are leading to the collapse of its military power. This is correction from God. But the Bible also prophesies that when this correction becomes intense enough, people will acknowledge their transgressions, repent, and seek God. To learn more about why God is correcting the United States, request a free copy of The United States and Britain in Prophecy by Herbert W. Armstrong.